Hello, welcome to friends. In the next lecture on tenses, I am Prachi Vani. Welcome you all in this lecture. We will have the next discussion about the tenses. The tenses are very important part of grammar. Usually, you can take any language for communication purposes. If you are not using appropriate tense, then the communication will become here meaningless and chaotic. To avoid all that kind of the problems, every learner of language must be able to use the tenses in their day-to-day communication. Before that, how tenses will be very important, we are going to see the course outcome. After learning tenses, the students will be able to formulate grammatically correct sentences. Majority of the regional students, regional people, they are having the problem to communicate in English because they are not that much aware about the tenses that they are using. Hence, in order to formulate grammatically correct sentences, tenses is very important. Rather, we can say it as a soul of a language. When we are taking any language for communication purposes, then we use the tenses, and without it we cannot talk. Next, after learning it, definitely it will improve the writing as well as speaking skill. In writing skill, the student will be able to use correct form of tenses in every type of situation. And in speaking skill, the student will be able to apply appropriate tenses in the spoken language. So when we are having our communication with anyone who is from the another sectors, another region, then we should have proper communication, interaction with them. It is depend upon how we are fluent in the tenses. Now let us try to understand the concept of tenses. In school, already we have studied in detail. Now I am going to just refresh you, recap you, so that we will be able to use appropriate verb form in the given exercises. Maybe sometimes incorrect verb are used, so we have to make it correct. Now let us start with the tenses. Tenses always express time reference. In which time, at which time we are saying something, it is easily indicated with the tenses. So tenses are indicated through the verbs. As we have seen, the sentence construction. The sentence is made up of subject, verb and object. So generally, in which tense the given sentence is, it is easily identified by just going through the verbs. So the student must be able to identify the verb and identify the tense used in that sentence. For effective communication, we have to communicate in appropriate tense. So majorly, as we know, there are three types of tenses, that is present tense, past tense and future tense. Now for all that three tenses, we have some sub tenses, as we have seen, that is simple, continuous, perfect, perfect continuous. So if it is simple present tense, the main thing is here verb, that is main verb, we have to use it, and as per the tenses we have to do necessary changes. Continuous tense, as you know, it must have the form of to be plus ving form, means verb plus ing. Then in perfect tense, we should use here the forms of to have and immediately after. As we know, if have is used, then we have to use here v3 form, that is the third form of verb. That is, for example, speak, spoke, spoken. So speak is a v1, spoke is a v2 and spoken is a v3. If it is perfect continuous tense, then this structure generally we use, that is to have, form of have plus being plus again ving. So these are the common, already we have studied. Now we are going to discuss the next one. Now we are going to discuss the usage of tenses. Let us try for the first, that is present tense. In present tense, we are going to discuss simple present tense. Now, simple present tense can be used to indicate the habitual action. Also, it is used to tell the truth or facts about something. It is also used to tell about future event. very close future event, and even then we can use their simple present tense. Even in quotations also, we can use simple present tense to give some moral, to give some teaching or lessons. In conditional clauses, even simple present tense is used. Now let us, we will see one by one. The habitual action. The manager gets up at 5 in the morning. This is habitual action of manager. The earth revolves around the sun. That is true fact, unchallengeable. So the earth revolves around the sun. Whenever we are telling some facts, usually we use simple present tense. If we have to quote here future event, very coming future event, even then we use it in the simple present. Like the train leaves at 3 p.m. sharp. That is, this is the departure time of train. So very soon it is going to leave. Then in quotation, Swami Vivekananda says, rise, awake, and do not stop until you reach to the goal. If someone has given a very good moral, definitely it can be indicated with the simple present. And in conditional clause, that is if sentences, if you heat water 100 degrees, it starts boiling. So in both conditional clauses, we use your simple present tense in the given clause. Now let us, we will go the next, that is present continuous tense. Present continuous tense shows progressive action of something in the present. Like happening action, an action may not be happening at the time of speaking, even then we use generally present continuous tense. If we have to say something about definite future arrangement, definitely you can use your present continuous tense. And habits happen often, even then we use present continuous tense. So at a large, we use present continuous tense when action is going on, when action is in a progressive condition, then present continuous tense is used. For example, I am just leaving office. Justly, I am leaving my office. Next, action may not be happening at the time of speaking, even then sometimes we are using present continuous tense. For example, aren't you teaching at the university now? Means nowadays this is your current profession, current designation, post that you are teaching at the university now. So in interrogative format, we also use present continuous tense. In definite future arrangement, we use this tense. I am going to the party tonight. This is my definite plan for evening, for my tonight. Then present continuous tense is used with the help of going to this place. Then habits happen often, that is on a regular basis. Abhijit is always smiling. Means Abhijit is having his face, that he is always having a smile on a face. So for that purpose we use present continuous tense. Then the next tense is your present perfect tense. Generally, the keywords I have given there, that is since, recently, now, just, these are the keywords that gives us idea that we have to use your present perfect tense or present tense. Recently completed action can be indicated with this. For example, I have just finished my lunch. Unspecified past action, that is I have never traveled by bus. Unspecified past action. We don't know when I started this action of non-traveling and when it is still it is continued. But even then, when we don't know the specific time of a past, but even then it is written in the present perfect tense. That is, I have never traveled by bus. Something started in the past and continued up until now, then present perfect tense is used. For example, Rashmi has been in England for 6 months. So Rashmi, she is residing in England in the past and still she is continued for 6 months. So has been in England. So has been, that kind of the construction can be used under present perfect tense. Next is present perfect continuous tense. It indicates the action starts in the present at some time and continues in the present at the time we are using fourth number of tense. Very rarely we are using. She has been writing her homework since afternoon. She has been writing her homework since afternoon. So this is continued. She started this action in the present and still she is continuing this activity in the afternoon itself. So these are the sub tenses of present tense. Now we are going to discuss about the past tense. So past tense contains simple past tense. Again, there are some of the keywords I would like to tell you. That is, an year ago, last year, when I was young. When there is a specific time is given into the past, at the time simple past tense is used to express ideas that started and finished at specific time. Then past tense is used. For example, he didn't see any movie yesterday. It means he have not seen any movie yesterday. Describe the past habits. They never went to school. So if we have to describe the past habits of the person, then we can use this in a simple past tense. Now past continuous tense, that is action, progressive action in the past, action going on in the past, then we can use it past continuous tense. For example, Kavya was enjoying the games at a fun fair. So Kavya was enjoying games at fun fair. Persistent habit in the past, that is continuous habits in the past. She was always coming to the class late. Sometimes any student, if he or she is coming late always, then it is saying, or it is said that she was always coming to the class late. Third is past perfect tense. It indicates completed action in the past. That is, I had never seen such a beautiful beach. So it indicates completed action in the past. Or sometimes when there are two clauses have been given there in a one sentence, then past perfect tense indicates earlier action. Let us see. When I reached, the train had already left. So the earlier action is here, leaving of a train, and next action is here, reaching. So next action is always indicated with the simple past, and earlier action is indicated with the past perfect tense. So do not forget, whenever such type of sentences occur in the exercise, we have to first of all find out which is the previous action and which is the next action. So next action is always represented with the simple past and previous action is always represented with the past perfect. Next is your future tense. Simple future tense, that is uncontrollable future activity. These are shown or these are articulated with the simple future tense. It will be Holi in a week. In this week, if I have to say that Holi, this festival is coming, so I will be using a simple future tense. It will be Holi in a week. Future action can be easily indicated that it is, I think Brazil will win the cup. So if I have to mention the future action and I am just here is going to guess, then simple future is used. That is, I think Brazil will win the cup. Then future continuous tense, that is action going on at some time in future. So she will be writing an assignment in the evening. If I am going to here think about the future activity and I am guessing, then future activity can be here given. That is, she will be writing an assignment in the evening. Future perfect tense, that is completed action in the future. I might have completed my study by next Monday. So by next Monday, I might have completed my job, my study, my assignment, then my project. So I'm just going to guess. Yes, I'm predicting that I'm going to complete all that kind of the activities. So this is future tense. Now on the basis of usages of tenses, we will guess how the given sentences are put. The red color highlighted word indicates answer. Who invented the bicycle? Obviously, who invented? This is much back activity, so it refers to the specific time in the past. So we are using a simple past. Second, there I notice how important it is to use English nowadays. there I noticed the action is over. So for that purpose we are using here noticed. How important it is, the form of to be we have to use. The forms of to be are here am, is, are, was, were. So upon, among all we have to select appropriate one, and this is applicable nowadays. So at present analyze it, how it is to use, how important it is to use English. Third is here, he go to that place every year. This is habitual action, so it is indicated with the simple present. So he goes to that place every year. Fourth, when I met you last time, you think for moving to a new flat. So this is past activity. When I met you last time, you were thinking for moving to new flat. The thinking was going on. If I pass in the exam, I start apprenticeship. Conditional clause, if I pass in the exam, I will start apprenticeship. So here again conditions have been given. The sun shines brightly. The sun shines brightly, that is simple present tense. Shikhar Dhawan scored century in the last match. So scored, because it has its relevance with the last match. This the keywords that gives us idea of the past action. So simple present, the simple past. She understood the movie as only she read the novel. She read the novel. This is a simple past. While I do the language course, I meet young people from all over the world. So this refers to the past activity. That is, while I was doing the language course, I met young people from all over the world. So all that words indicates here the past activity. I get hungry, let's have a breakfast. So you can go for I get hungry, let's have a breakfast. I got hungry, let's have a breakfast. Or I'm getting hungry, let's have a breakfast. So in this way, multiple practices may be able to make you very much proficient in selecting appropriate verb form in the given places. So thank you very much. You can refer this video again and again so that you will be able to solve the question over here. Thank you very much.